I see everybody getting their drink on. That is great. Drink some for me. I had to quit drinking not too long ago. It's a big tragedy. Had to quit drinking because I was blacking out all the time. You know what I mean? You wake up in the morning and you're like, what happened? It was never anything cool. Never, ever, ever. I never had that cool blackout story. There's always one guy at the party, wake him up the next day. It's like, oh man, Joe, you were awesome last night. You left the party with 17 hot girls. You found a $100 bill on the ground. You broke up a fight. You saved a baby from a burning building, Joe. You walked on the moon. There's a parade waiting for you after you get dressed. It's going to be on CNN. Happy Tuesday, Joe. You're my new hero. My blackouts were like, Ken, you peed on the couch. The neighbor's couch. While they were watching Matlock. The cool part is we taped it and we posted it on YouTube, so you're famous now. High five. It's a big hit in Germany. I do love YouTube, though. I love watching crazy people on YouTube. I saw a guy who swears he has proof that Barack Obama's mother-in-law is practicing voodoo in the White House. Witchcraft in the White House bedroom. Now, I love Barack Obama, but if that were true, it would be the greatest thing on the face of the earth. Because if Barack Obama showed up to a press conference about Afghanistan, or Iran, or Libya, or any old thing, with some little old lady trailing behind him, rattling chicken bones around, she throws some flash powder, they cut open a note, and spread the floor on his face, and goes, what, buggers? Nobody will ever mess with us, never, ever, ever. Robot drone bombers plus voodoo equals peace in the Middle East. I'm not around here. I live in San Francisco. I'm originally from North Carolina. And I have to tell you, I love living in San Francisco, but that place still, to this day, kind of scares the shit out of me a little bit. And here's why. I never know at any given time what's going to piss those people off. Like when I found out I was moving to San Francisco, I got excited. I was like, oh, that's where the crazy people live. This is going to be awesome. This is going to be just like joining the circus. And it is kind of like joining the circus, but it's a circus where all the clowns are pissed off all the time. I didn't know plastic bags was a thing. That's how ignorant I am. I didn't know plastic bags was some shit to be mad about. I had no idea until I saw 50 bazillion hippies marching down the street in San Francisco. We hate plastic bags. We hate plastic bags. We hate plastic bags. We love weed. We hate plastic bags. We love weed. And I have to tell them, California, San Francisco, what you gonna put your weed in? They didn't think that through. And they do love weed. Good Lord, I used to smoke weed every single day, many, many times a day for many, many years. And I thought, man, I am weed's number one fan. No! Not even in the same neighborhood. You guys are catching up, Colorado. I saw that medicinal marijuana place out front out there. Y'all are catching up, but still, nobody loves weed like California. You know, East Coast thinks they love. New York, they're like, hey, we love weed. I lived in Washington, D.C. for a minute. They're like, we love weed. We love crack, but we love weed too. Where I come from, we huff paint. But in our wildest, bug-eyed, huffiest frenzy, it never, ever, ever occurred to us to legislate it. There are no medicinal paint cards. Nobody's going. going down to Sherwin Williams, I need a little acrylic for my glaucoma. No! Here's how much they love weed in San Francisco. I went to an outdoor, 3-day outdoor concert festival. It was all free. 600,000 people showed up. Nice weather, everybody's having a good time. But before every single act, somebody from the city of San Francisco got a call the PA system and says, ladies and gentlemen, the city of San Francisco, Golden Gate Park would like to remind you that you can smoke marijuana, but not tobacco, in Golden Gate Park. That's crazy. And I, you know, I'm from North Carolina. I smoke and dip at the same time. I gotta have that shit, right? So I'm like, let me test the waters here. I light up a cigarette. Sure enough, 600,000 people all at once part like the Red Sea of Intolerance. And in San Francisco, nobody gets aggressive in that town. They just get disappointed. So I got 600,000 of these. So I just threw a bunch of plastic bags in there.